The Last of Us Part 2 has been such a complete disaster. Tons of footage was leaked online. Sony and Naughty Dog have been striking creators for showing and simply discussing the leaks. Their bots literally struck down their own trailer on Twitter, which is hilarious, and karma is a heckin' bitch. Then you have game journalists complaining about how they didn't get review copies, so they won't support the game because of that. And to top it all off, the game's appeal has just completely fallen off a cliff for me personally. There's just been so many wrong choices surrounding it, and the way that they've handled situations has been extremely unprofessional. But there is some more news for The Last of Us Part 2, because it is apparently being banned in several countries. This is abounding into comics article. Sony reportedly confirms that The Last of Us Part 2 has been banned in the Middle East after a fan inquiry. Naughty Dog's upcoming and highly controversial continuation of Ellie and Joel's story is set to see another setback to its release, as Sony has seemingly confirmed that The Last of Us Part 2 has been banned in the Middle East. The confirmation first appeared on the subreddit r/DubaiGaming, where a user shared a screenshot of an email he had received from PlayStation support. After being unable to find the game on the PlayStation store, the user reached out to support staff to ask why The Last of Us Part 2 wasn't available for pre-order in the PlayStation storefront, only to receive a statement informing them that if any game did not exist in the store region, that means the game had been banned by the competent authorities of the country. As you can see from the screenshot, it says, "Thank you for your email. If any game does not exist in any storefront in a region, that means the game has been banned by the competent authorities of the country and we cannot do anything regarding that. I hope that this helps, but if you need anything else, just let me know. Thank you." As the article continues to point out, though, confusingly, the PlayStation Twitter account, an official website for the Middle East region, has publicized the game's release, promoting the upcoming The Last of Us 2 Focus State of Play broadcast and featuring the game on a coming soon list, respectively. Though no official reason for the ban was given by the PlayStation Store staff member, speculation has centered on the region's heavy adherence to the Islamic religion, which takes particular issue with sexual content, nudity, and the promotion of LGBT+ lifestyles. Now, I feel that it is important to point out that if you go to the list of banned video games, there are a lot of games banned by places in the Middle East. We have Saudi Arabia's list. I'm not going to read all of them because there are so many, but we have, you know, Grand Theft Auto series banned for extreme impact, violence, and nudity. LA Noir banned because of extreme impact, violence, and nudity. We have Postal 2 banned because of impact violence. We have Red Dead Redemption 1 and 2 banned due to nudity, prostitution, violence, and cruelty. We have Manhunt 2 banned for gross, unrelenting, and gratuitous violence. If you've heard The Last of Us 2 spoilers, there's going to be quite a few, how do I say this without spoiling anything? Very violent moments. If we go down to the United Arab Emirates, let's look at several of them. We have the BlazBlue Continuum Shift, likely due to suggestive and revealing outfits on some characters. Dead Island, extreme depictions of violence in scantily clad game characters. Dead Rising 2, banned likely due to violence, gambling, and nudity. So as you can see, that none of this is new. Unfortunately, this isn't an isolated incident. It's nothing new for these regions. They ban violence and sexual content of all kinds, and they have for a very long time. And as the Bounding Into Comics article points out, we have that added layer of sexual content in this game that is centered around an LGBTQ relationship. This is censorship, and censorship that definitely does not get a lot of attention, because as far as the entertainment world goes, it doesn't really seem like this region has had a big impact on the industry, unlike China, so we don't end up discussing it as often. But it is extremely important because it is still censorship, and censorship anywhere in the world, especially with how connected everything is, down the line could affect everywhere and everyone else, just like we talk about when it comes to China. Look, there are a lot of problems in the Middle East that are extremely important when it comes to things like human rights. And for any modern-day Western feminists out there, instead of creating fake outrage on the internet about perceived injustices and inequalities that don't actually exist in regions like the US and a lot of Europe, you need to take a hard look at where the real problems are, where women really don't have any rights. It's pretty suspicious that no one is talking about this and no one is outraged about this online when they would be outraged about an LGBTQ game being banned, if it ever was, in regions like the United States. But let everyone know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Are you very surprised by this? After looking at the list of banned video games, I'm not particularly shocked about this unfortunate ban, but just because I am not going to purchase it, or just because I'm very excited for it, does not mean that I want it banned, especially when other people may enjoy it. But that is all that I had to discuss in this video. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to give it a like, and of course, if you did not, make sure to give it a dislike. I appreciate your support either way, and I will talk to you all again in the next video really soon.